Academy in Brightstow in Bristol. Are you ready for your first question? Over.
I'm ready, and it's great to be speaking to you of the Academy in Bristol.
Hi, my name is Emily. From my research, I found out that you are taking part in 265 experiments. Which one is most important for us here on Earth? Over.
GB1SS, this is Golf Bravo 1 Oscar Alpha Bravo. Are you receiving? Over.
Golf Bravo 1 Oscar Alpha Bravo, this is Golf Bravo 1 Sierra Sierra. I read you loud and clear. I didn't hear the question at all. Over.
No, didn't hear the question.
Hi, my name is Emily. From my research, I have found out that you are taking part in 265 experiments. Which one is most important for us here on Earth? Over.
Hi Emily, that's a great question. It's difficult to choose just one, and I wouldn't like to show favoritism, but I think the most important ones for people back on Earth are the ones that are looking into medical research, research into vaccinations, into new drugs, and also into ways of recycling clean energy. We recycle all of our water, we use solar panel up here. So I think energy and medicine are the two major topics which will help people on Earth. Over.
Hello, this is Luke. In your opinion, will unmanned missions ever be equal to manned ones? Over.
Hi Luke, I think unmanned missions are extremely important. We've explored so much of our solar system, and we still have a lot of exploring to do. Unmanned missions are lower risk and lower cost, but ultimately, I think we'll always be more excited about human exploration. Over.
Hi,
I'm curious, did anything in your previous career or experiences prepare you for space? Over.
I feel like I've been preparing for space since I was a teenager. Everything I've done in all of my jobs has really helped me and prepared me for this mission. Over.
Hi, I'm Jacob. Why did you want to become an astronaut? Over.
Ooh.
Hi, Jacob. Well, for me, it was the pinnacle of our flying career. Being a test pilot, you push boundaries, you explore new things, and to go into space to explore new frontiers and to be at the cutting edge of technology for me was just the height of my professional career. Over.
Hi, Tim. It's Les and Pete from The One Show. We spoke to Helen on the
Near
Space
Station 25 years ago.
Whoa.
We asked her
whether she could see any satellites, and there are a lot more now.
So even The One Show is involved with this.
Hey, you know, I haven't seen any with the naked eye, but when I've gone back and looked at some of my time-lapse photographs, I can easily see lots of satellites on my time-lapse photographs, but not notice them with the naked eye.
Over. Sees on
this. Hi, my name is Emily. When you push on the wall of the space station behind you to move forward, does the space station move backwards due to the principle of conservation of momentum? Over.
I have a great question, and yes, it would do, but I weigh only 70 kilograms. The space station weighs 400 tons, so I won't make much of an impact. Over.
Hello, this is Luke. What do you think of NASA's planned one-way Mars mission, and would you go if given the opportunity? Over.
Hi, Luke. Well, NASA doesn't really have a one-way planned mission to Mars. They're the more commercial companies doing that. NASA wants to go there and return their astronauts to Earth. Which I think is what we should be striving for, to actually explore Mars for all the astronauts to come home. Over.
This is Francesca again. Can you feel the International Space Station shake or wobble? Over.
Hi, Francesca. Great question. Not really, but what you can feel it do is do a reboot. And the other day, I floated about 5 seconds before the reboot and watched myself drift backwards through the space station as the space station was boosted forwards. Over.
Hi, this is Seymour again. Being in a microgravity environment causes a decrease in muscle mass and bone density. Other than exercise, what measures are you taking to protect your health? Over.
Hi, Seymour. Well, you mentioned exercise. The only other thing we can really do is well, so we try and look after our nutrition up here as well and try and prevent any of the negative effects of microgravity. Over.
Hi, this is Jack again. Considering that in space you are weighing
and
time has a different value, do you age at
species.
A different rate? Over.
I don't think we've got time to go into Einstein's equations, but the answer is yes, by fractions of a second I'll be a little bit younger when I come home due to the fact we're traveling so far. Over.
Hi, it's Karis again. Astronauts go through such lengthy and intensive training for their journeys. Was there anything that you were not prepared for? Over.
Hi, Karen. Great question. I do know our training was so good, I think it prepared us for everything. But the story is the physical feelings and the noises of that Soyuz launch and coming up into Earth's orbit, that was remarkable, and no training could really prepare you for the sounds and the feelings of a rocket launch. Over.
Hi, it's Jacob again. How are your experiments helping to save Earth? Over.
Hi, Jacob. Well, experiments that we've done in space have helped with vaccinations for things like salmonella and for investigating MRSA. They've helped us to develop water recycling systems that can be used in third world countries. We're trying to solve lots of problems regarding ancient medicine and the Earth's climate.
GB1SS, GB1SS, this is Golf Bravo 1, Oscar Alpha Bravo. Tim, that was absolutely amazing. Yeah. Everybody here wants to send their appreciation to GB1SS, GB1SS, this is Golf Bravo 1, Oscar Alpha Bravo. Tim, absolutely brilliant. Give us a wave before you... Oh, you're gone. absolutely brilliant. You're doing a wonderful job and everyone here is really proud of it. This is GB1 Oscar Alpha Bravo handing back to GB1 SS for a final. GB1 Oscar Alpha Bravo out.
Amazing.